This is a fan-generated show. If you would like to support us, please go to jamieglazov.com and also don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. All your support is greatly appreciated.
Good evening. Welcome to the Glazov Gang. Tonight, our very special guest, Dr. Anna Geifman, the author of Death Orders. Dr. Geifman, welcome to the Glazov Gang.
Thank you very much.
Nice to see you again. You are in Israel. The country is under attack. We just saw a horrible recent terror attack, as all of them are horrible. A Muslim terrorist drove his car into a bus stop, jumped out with a cleaver and started slashing people. He killed a rabbi. As somebody that's in Israel, tell us how you see what's happening there.
Well, it's a new phase of the old war. Why is it a new phase? Because we can't really put your finger on who's directly responsible. The terrorist attacks have not been organized. If we mean by organized, we mean people being part of a particular movement or a particular terrorist organization. That is not to say that there are no people behind these attacks. Of course, there are, and the primary reason for the escalation, as we call it, is incitement. In fact, if you look at the situation, you know, we're talking about years and years, decades of incitement. Constant reminders to the Palestinian youth, for example, that a martyr in Jerusalem, and all those people, practically most people most terrorists who have attacked in Jerusalem have been neutralized, have been eliminated. In the eyes, in the propaganda that is going on, they're martyrs, and to be a martyr in Jerusalem is not just a good thing; it's the best thing that can happen. So, and it's been going on for decades. So. While these terrorist attacks are not organized in the sense that the movement may be spontaneous, and spontaneously people get contacted on the social media, on website, on Facebook, and through other means, and new so-called martyrs emerge, not members of an organization, but just young people who get sucked into this movement. There are people there are forces that who are behind them, who are behind this escalation. Whether or not, you know, of course, there's been discussion as to whether or not Mahmoud Abbas is personally responsible. And, you know, it's a long story. His position is very difficult. You know, on the one hand, he's been pressed by the Hamas to break all the dealings with the Israelis and join the revolution, as it's called. On the other hand, I'm not sure that he personally finds it beneficial. It's complicated. He has to sort of play the two sides against each other. You know, it's complicated. But we know for a fact that he's been inciting. He's been saying things like, we're not going to, yesterday he said, we're not going to give up in our struggle for the liberation of the Al-Aqsa or protection of Al-Aqsa. Nobody's trying to assault it. Nobody's trying to take it away from them. Nobody's trying to do anything to Al-Aqsa. This is absolutely random. There's not, as far as Israeli policy is concerned, there's no indication, and the government has said it multiple times, that there's no attempt to take it away or to change the status of it. It's just being used to the argument that it's supposedly being taken from the Muslim aims to turn this whole discussion into God forbid a holy war. And Abbas has been doing that as well as other Palestinian leaders.
Thank you, Dr. Geifman. Let me ask you this. We just have a little bit of time left. You are dealing with a death cult, correct?
It depends. Depends on who you're talking about. You are dealing with the death cult in the sense that there are people behind behind the people who are interested in building a particular and a real culture, a real culture in which the young people are grow up, and exactly dealing, you know, with the generation. Most terrorists, of course, are very young, and we're dealing. Most of them are the post-Oslo generation, post-1993 generation. They have been objects. They've been played with. They've been turned into martyrs by precisely because they've been living in this culture of death.
Dr. Geifman, in terms of dealing with this Palestinian death cult, and I would argue also an Islamic death cult, we have John Kerry at the same time. You know, he's thinking the Jews are just building too many settlements right now. That's what the problem is. I mean, this is just shameful and shameless.
This is certainly not the question of settlements. Most attacks have taken place in Jerusalem, which is obviously not a settlement. There, two latest attacks happened in Ra'anana, which has nothing to do with the settlement issue. It's just a regular propaganda device.
Dr. Geifman, before we go, is somebody living in Israel? What is it like? I mean, I can only imagine living in a society where any moment a car could drive into a bus stop and a person jumps out with a cleaver and starts trying to kill me. I mean, is there a sense of fear, of depression or paranoia? Or what? It must be terrifying to live under these circumstances.
It depends on the person, of course. It helps a great deal to know why you're here. For people, I would say that who have a very strong sense of identity, Jewish identity, and a sense of belonging, and a sense of this is our home. It's much easier than for those who have whose Zionist sentiments or whose Jewish identity has not been as pronounced. It's interesting, you know, I've heard the program yesterday, I think, that it's, you'd think, you know, the children and the elderly are most scared. It turns out it's not really the case. As far as the elderly are concerned, you know, they've been through so much. They've been through so many wars and so many problems. They take everything very calmly. The children benefit. I should say that the children benefit a great deal if the parents retain the sense of commitment, sense of value, sense of meaning, and deal with the children based on not project the fears onto them, but project the truth and the right values.
Dr. Geifman, we are out of time. Under 20 seconds, please, your message to the world.
The peace, but not at the expense of humiliation and losing yourself and losing a sense of right and wrong. Really, people should, I really hope that by looking at the situation that is going on in Israel, in Jerusalem, people will start thinking about the things that truly matter. Things like values, things like goodness, things like meaningful life, things like the truly important things that define not just physical existence but life as it should be. I might have quoted this in the previous program. We are told in the Torah, to choose life. It's not that clear. Of course, everyone would say, "Yeah, of course, I choose life. Obviously, I want to live rather than die." But what this means, what it really means to choose life, is people should be thinking about this. You know, I would say this is one of the most important questions in in the spiritual life of the world today, everywhere, not just in Israel.
Thank you so much, Dr. Geifman. The Glazov gang, unlike the Obama administration, is standing with you, with Israel. We love Israel, and we wish you the best there, and God bless you. Thank you. Thank you for joining the Glazov gang, and we'll see you on the next edition of the Glazov gang. Good night.